Make any driver's blood pressure rise. You're driving along, then suddenly behind you come sirens and flashing lights.
The problem is a surprising number of people don't know what to do when that happens, and emergency services have had enough.
An average day on Auckland's motorways, and it's not long before Sergeant Andrew Meal gets a call out. But getting there isn't easy.
It's not even indicating to pull over.
That's because of drivers not pulling over or pulling over the wrong way.
Why would you do that? You've got a massive gap there to the left.
In a short space of time, it happened over and over again.
This truck driver's not looking in his mirrors.
It took this driver an entire minute before they got the message and got out of the way.
So this is so bad, I'll phone the owner or manager of this company, and I'll also send them a notice requiring them to tell me who the driver's details are. He'll definitely get a ticket for failing to give way.
St John paramedics encounter it every day.
Every second counts in somebody's emergency. We don't really need that extra level of stress when we're going to somebody's life-threatening emergency.
Sergeant Meal puts it down to a few factors.
I think one of the obvious ones is people just aren't checking their mirrors. And they're, under the road code, you're supposed to check your mirrors every 15 seconds. People using Bluetooth devices are, engrossed in conversations on phones with the windows up. It makes it harder to hear the sirens. Certainly music loud, with windows up makes it very hard to hear the sirens. Probably even with windows down, it's hard to hear the sirens if you've got your music up loud. We're getting too many instances of people just slowing right down in that lane, expecting us to go round them, or even coming to a stop. And on a lot of occasions, people will actually pull to the right instead of the left. We drive on the left-hand side of the road in New Zealand, so the expectation is that people will move to the left, to get out of the way of an emergency vehicle.
It's not only a problem on motorways and in big cities, it happens in the suburbs too.
It would have been helpful if she stopped when she could see us coming towards her.
You can get a $150 fine for not pulling over, not to mention putting someone's life at risk. So what do you do?
Yeah, pull over to the left, check your mirrors, get out of our way. Please, thanks to those who do.
And for people who like their music blaring, turn it down. You're in a car, not a nightclub.
I hear that siren and I just immediately feel guilty. Even if it's miles away, even if it's in a completely different lane, I suddenly think, what did I do? What did I do?
Well, it's funny you say that, because just the other day I was in the car with Hillary and that's exactly what happened. She heard a siren and immediately pulled over, obviously a habit, pulling over because she's so used to being pulled over. But it turns out the siren was coming the other way.
But that's good practice. I mean, if you're on the motorway, obviously you've got the barrier there, so that makes no difference. But if it was just a regular kind of two-way street, then me pulling over could be helpful if the copper had to overtake a vehicle coming the other way.
How quick were you onto the... She's like, whoop!